So loading an image from internet. You want to load an image from internet, you will be wanting to use this library called Universal Image Loader. There are other methods for loading an image, but as you see, takes a lot of code for just a simple operation as image loading. So let's go ahead and add this library to our Gradle files. Just search Google Android Universal Image Loader. Then you want to click quick setup. And here we have our Gradle dependency. So I already added here. And the next thing it tells us to add the permission for internet and write external storage. So you want to cache the images on your SD card. So this means editing your Android manifest XML with these two permissions. After, it says that this application or activity class before the first usage of image loader needs to be initialized with some configuration files. And we will initialize this for the whole application that we will use and how to do this. In our manifest under application, we add it a name and we call it .base application. And here we create a new class that extends the application called base application. And inside it we can write all the initialization of the libraries that we are going to use. So how to initialize this image loader. There are two things, a config and some display image options. And here I create a method called initImageLoader. In fact, I just copy paste it from the sample that you can find here. Okay, and yeah, feel free to just copy this. And after this, at on create, I call this method with a get application context. And also the simple image option. I made a public static display image option with simple image options with these parameters. Of course, you can add more, like there are lots of parameters here that you can use, like I don't know, whichever you want. I made it public static so I can import it easy in my activity. And all we have to do in our activity that we want to load an image from internet is to initialize this image loader with get instance and pass a display image containing. And now if you press Ctrl P, you have here some options, the string URI, the image view, and the display image option. And we have our string, our Obama. Let's take another one. Our image view, which is this file here with this ID, image view main, and the simple image option that just display a simple image without any pre-processing. For example, I will show you in a moment after we test this up. If we want to display a round image, we can just modify this displayer to round bitmap displayer with the radius of 300. You can play around a little with this radius to see how it the value that works for you, but let's just keep it to simple display, simple bitmap displayer. Okay, now as a homework, it's a very simple one. You just have to read everything from here, so this page and this page is too, like the quick setup, just read them, the configuration, have a look at this file, the display options, also have a look at these files, read the useful info. Just read them so you have an idea what's this library about. Yeah, and this should be it. Now, by using this library in your application, you save lots of time and lots of effort dealing with images from internet, and we will use it when we create more complex stuff like list views with images or grid images with images, grid view with images.